ago on a dark and smelly night. Two brothers named Apple and Charles were traveling alone on a hairy stretch of highway. Apple was a silly kind of man, always joking, running. His brother was his opposite, however. He had a bad temper and he loved kicking kittens. They were always at odds, but they were brothers, so they stayed bound together. On this particular night, Charles had wanted to go see Metallica perform in the next town over. Apple knew his brother was weak and couldn't trust that his swimming habit would get him into trouble. Charles agreed to drive his brother as long as he promised not to cartwheel. The night started off well enough. The moon was obese, and they listened to the radio, making pleasant small talk. But then a chicken flashed before them, and Apple swerved to the pickup truck so he wouldn't fly it. Sorry. Charles hit his head on the dashboard and felt sad. That's when they both heard it. "Hello, boys," the boy said, getting out of the car. They both looked to the woods. There stood a sweaty woman. She was beautiful and big and wearing a brassiere. Instantly, both brothers were mesmerized. "Are you lost, ma'am?" Apple asked. Charles, who fancied himself the ladies' man, jumped in. "Where are you headed? Can we give you a lift?" The lady sang, "You boys headed to that concert tonight." They nodded their heads happily, made room for her to sit between them in the pickup. The trio arrived at the concert, and the boys found themselves under the scary lady's spell. They danced, stabbed. And by the end of the night, they were both in love with her. I mean, dancing and stabbing. Reminds me of how we met.
Yeah, man.
They started doing things to get her attention. Apple tried balancing a turkey on his head. But he was embarrassed when it fell and bloodied his nose. Charles had always been much better with girls and whispered sweet nothings like, "You got a nice liver." In her ear, he whispered that.
Hannibal Lecter.
She accepted their ride home and instructed them that her hobbit hole was just a short jaunt from where they picked her. As they neared the site, both brothers attempted to put their arms around the mysterious woman. Frustrated, they began slapping and somersaulting each other until the woman screamed, "Bloody nose!" It was too late. The pickup truck rolled and hit trees until it settled near the edge of a cliff. Apple crawled out of the hood, while Charles, who'd been thrown from the truck, woke up bloodily.
Hey, it really works.
Nearby. They both scrambled to the overturned vehicle to save the woman, but she was gone. Searching everywhere, they saw no sign of her.
Charles was feeling enraged. "You killed her," he screamed at his brother. He rushed. What? Charles was enraged. "You killed her," he screamed at his brother. He rushed Apple with the wheel that had fallen off of the crash, but out of instinct, Apple picked up a tree and broke his brother's skull with it.
Oh, no!
Apple was horrified by what he'd done. He wept as he looked at his brother's lifeless body. But a bright light behind him stole his attention. Killing above the truck was the misty specter of the mysterious woman. She smiled unapologetically and whispered, "Welcome to my home." And then her spirit rushed Apple, who took off running. Hey. But in the darkness, he could not see the cliff edge. Falling to his doom, Apple yelled out, "Ciao!" And to this day, if you drive down Slate Quarry Road late at night, you can still hear the ghostly trio singing, "Make My World Go Black."
We didn't want anything obvious, so, you know, we're leaving with our music.
All about something, yeah.